So right here is just a Rubbermaid container that I found on the side of the road and some other stuff that people just threw out that they weren't doing anything with. And I just rigged up a little vermiculture setup to where vermiculture is composting with red wiggler worms, with little red worms. And some people call them fish worms, some people call them earthworms, but it's a specific type of worm that composts really, really well. They eat their own weight and food every single day. So basically, what we have here is some burlap, and I get vegetable scraps from a local juice bar where I actually work, and I bring them home, and Valerie brings home organic food scraps from the raw food restaurant she works at, and we bring them here, and we compost them, and you could see these little guys just completely going at it. It's full of worms, and this is the vegetable pulp material, and you could see it's just absolutely full of worms. I mean, they're in there by the billions, and it doesn't even smell. The system is really low maintenance, and these little guys eat their own weight every day, so I just put in probably 4 pounds of vegetable pulp from the back of a juicer, and it'll all turn into this black, I call it black gold, super amazing, rich,
see how it holds together like that and then it easily crumbles apart? That's when you can tell it's a really nicely structured soil. See, it holds together and then it crumbles.
And it's actually, what that is the castings from, it's actually earthworm poop. And it's totally odorless. It's rich in all kinds of minerals and enzymes.
Poop, I've been touching poop.
I've been touching poop as well. But this right here is, I mean, it's about as good as it gets. What we do with this is we'll take about 2 cups of that and put it in a 5-gallon bucket with water. We'll make a compost tea out of it. There's a process called compost tea, and we use, or worm casting tea, and we'll spray that on the garden, and it's kind of like a cure-all, super beneficial, highly preventative liquid tonic that you can give to your plants as much as you want.
Which is really nice in the beginning of doing this permaculture system, because you're still not, you don't have an intact ecosystem. You're building the ecosystem. So until it's there, until the fertility is back, this is a great way to get your plants
more resistant to pest problems. And you know, it's the we're in the city, so the resources are there. We can get unlimited vegetable scraps, unlimited juice pulp, unlimited coffee grounds, and all that stuff can just be converted into this right here, which is pretty much the foundation of soil.
The city is a wealth of resources to turn into fertility.
And then we also collect the juice, the effluent that comes out of the container, and that is just basically liquid plant food, and we'll pour it on the plants nearby the system here so we don't have to lug it all the way around. And so there's comfrey and other plants growing green manure crops, and we'll feed this to the comfrey, which is right behind you. And yeah, so super low maintenance. We come out here once a week and put food in there, and they just do it on their own. There are little workers. Just like everything else around here, everything kind of works for us, and we kind of skew the system and
guide it.